What's going on, guys? Welcome to Rabbit's Used Cars. You know, you meet some interesting characters with these old cars and dealing with them. And this little Corvair back here behind me was no different. You know, we went down to Daytona Beach to the Turkey Rod Run, and we had a great time riding around this little classic Corvair. It was a lot of fun. But I want to tell you something. Probably the biggest reason I bought this car was the guy that owned it. We got to talking to him, and he was such a character. And it was just so interesting. And this guy, I guess the best way to describe him, he was like the ladies' man of the retirement home. He lives in a retirement community called the Villages down in Florida. It's a 20-mile by 20-mile retirement, 55-up community. And, I mean, they have movie theaters and grocery stores and everything right there on site. It's like its own little town of old people. This guy has been rocking this Corvair in that retirement community for years. And the only reason he was selling it is they've changed all the rules and turned it into an entirely into a golf cart only community. So basically he wanted a new golf cart because he can't drive his Corvair around picking up old chicks at the retirement home. And you know, I got to talk to this guy and just some of the things he said, which I cannot repeat for YouTube. This guy was like literally the Corvair Casanova. We got to talking about it. Even after buying the car, me and the camera guy, my buddy Kobe was there with us. We got to talking about this guy, just some of the scenarios. I mean, this dude's probably had his hands on more fake hips than any two orthopedic surgeons you could put together. You know, you ever wonder why your grandma forgot to call you on your birthday? He's probably the reason why. This guy's, he was something else. Like, I mean, it was kind of funny because he's like 70, maybe a little older, had a flat bill hat on, 3 or 4 gold chains, and of course a medic alert bracelet. This guy was, you know, he was like Mr. Cool, reeked of aqua velva. Even the car still smells like aqua velva, which is nuts. We've had this thing with the top down for a month. The whole damn warehouse smells like aqua velva now. But anyway, and this guy was telling us about all the hot dates he went on in this Corvair. We got talking about cars, and he asked me, he said, what kind of cars you got? And I told him about my big block Camaros and my little Chevelle and my big block C10. And he said, I know you look at this little Corvair, you don't think much about it, having cars like that. He said, but I'm going to tell you something, bud. Where I'm from, when the guy next door has an easy go, this is like a big block Corvette compared to that. So we all laughed, and you know, it was kind of cool. And I mean, this guy apparently had quite the rep hanging out in the retirement community. So like anybody, we get, you know, a little curious about it. Yeah, you know, so we Googled this and we heard about this STD outbreak in the retirement community where this car came from, which first thing that popped in my mind, Lysol wipes. Second thing that popped in my mind was, what in the hell are these old people doing? And then we started laughing. And keep in mind, it's a long drive back from Daytona Beach. And we're riding back. And I mean, like the things that bob in my head. I mean, this guy right here puts the D in grandma, if you catch my drift. He runs on black coffee, Metamucil, and Viagra. I'll tell you something, osteoporosis ain't the only big O in that neighborhood, I promise you. Whew. I tell you what, have you ever noticed when your grandma limps sometime? It's that guy. You ever notice why your grandma sleeps late on Saturday mornings? Because he was there Friday night. I'm gonna tell you something else. This guy's the reason your grandma gets her hair done every week. But back to the car. It's a 1963 Corvair convertible. You know, they made a lot of these cars. They made the Chevrolet Corvair from 1960 to 1969. This car was actually originally built to kind of compete as a sporty car. It was actually originally built to compete with the import cars at the time. You gotta think about it, it's air-cooled, flat six, rear engine. It's a sporty car. It came in a coupe, convertible, and they even made a van. And they made a four-door also. They made a lot of variations of it, all, of course, rear engine, air-cooled. It drives a lot like a Volkswagen Bug. It's like driving the fastest Bug ever. Real peppy car, fun car to drive. And they even had a turbo version. Well, in 1965, there was a political activist slash novelist that kind of reigned on the Corvair's parade. He wrote a book. His name was Ralph Nader, and it was called Unsafe at Any Speed. And basically, he was talking about how the Corvair was an unsafe car because of it being rear-engine like it was, that at high speeds it got tail-happy. And I'm assuming by tail-happy means loose in the ass end. I'll be honest with you, what car in the 60s didn't do this? Rear-engine or not. But this book really, really put a damper on Corvair sales. You know, it made people think they weren't safe cars when really they weren't that bad. GM continued to make the Corvair. It's been rumored that they did it because of a pride thing. They didn't want a book to shut a car down. Also, it said that, you know, all the money that they invested in tooling for this car, that, you know, they run it for another few years to actually try to get some of their money back out of it. Because this car is a totally different platform. You got to think, you know, of the time, the Novas and the Malibus and everything like that, those were rear-wheel drive cars. This car has a flat floorboard in it. So it's a totally different layout. I mean, there's nothing on this car that's shared with any other GM car. Like many other GM cars do share a lot of parts. So it probably costs a lot of money to develop and make these things. You know, a lot of people consider the Corvair kind of a flop, but actually between 1960 and 1969, they made over 1.7 million Corvairs. Of the rarest of the Corvairs, though, was actually the Monza convertibles like this one behind me. And of course, they made a Spider and a turbo version that was also pretty rare. I mean, that's a pretty, pretty good run for this car. I mean, it was the very first and still the only American air-cooled rear engine car. So, I mean, it was kind of a breakthrough. And as for Ralph Nader in his book, you know, that came out in 1965 calling the car unsafe. Actually, so they quit making the Corvair in 1969. Well, in 1972, Texas A&M held a crash test with these cars, driving them at high speeds and doing different scenarios with them. And they actually debunked Ralph Nader's myth, claiming these cars were no more unsafe than any other car on the road at the time. So I guess whichever side you end up being on with that one, the Corvair was already a gone thing, but kind of interesting. Like I said, we had a ball in this thing in Daytona Beach. We drove it everywhere, drove it out on the beach, had a blast. It was a great car, great drop top, and I got a good buddy of mine that's gonna pick this one up and add it to his collection. I mean, you gotta think about it. This old girl right here has been pulling skirts since before they put a man on the moon and still works today. Guys, we'll catch you next time at Rabbit Used Cars.
Corvair Casanova, take one.
I tell you what, you meet a lot of interesting guys and girls too, even selling these cars and trucks and buying these cars and trucks. You know, it's like dog mode in the background. Oh, this guy was putting the D in assisted living.
This thing's topless.
Kind of wish you were.
You're not that good of a salesman.
My job sucks. I'm kind of like spaghetti. I'm better the second day. I like that. I like that. We got just enough time to take old Darth Nader on a cruise before she heads to her new home.
Darth Nader.
Darth Nader. Nader.
Can't say Vader. Just
Nader.
Darth Nader.
10-2, mister.
You think I should have said gonorrhea? Do you think syphilis would have been better?
Aren't you my dad's age?
I hate my life. He's the reason your grandma gets her hair done every week. You know when your grandma's limping sometimes?
Don't you think you're a little old for ripped jeans?
What the hell are ripped jeans?
You know, when your grandma sleeps in on Saturday mornings, it's because he was there Friday night.
You know, I heard everything gets better with age, and the car looks great, but what happened to you?
Millennials. He runs on black coffee, Metamucil, and Viagra.
I think my grandpa has a car like this.
Does he live in Florida?
the big O around this guy isn't osteoporosis, I promise you.
Ew, what are you doing? You're like one of those old men from Florida.
that's a good one. So we were... Whoa, 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 ma'am. I'm not that kind of guy. Well, maybe I am.